We will solve H.C. Verma problem 63, chapter 8. It's a useful problem with some concepts. What is given is a sphere of radius R. The surface of the sphere is smooth. There is a chain. The length of chain is L. So the arc which the chain will subtend, chain is right now placed like this. Start from the topmost point. The angle subtended by chain would be angle alpha would be L upon R. And mass per unit length lambda would be M upon L. We have to find out three things. First, what is the gravitational potential energy at this situation where the chain has just started sliding down? Number two, we have to find the velocity of the chain when it slides through an angle theta, when it comes to this angle. This is the initial position, the new angle, initial angle by this point was zero, now it makes an angle theta. And the total angle subtended is this. Let it be like this. This angle is alpha, this is theta. What will be the velocity here and also the acceleration when it is at this point? Now, in such problems, we should always take a small element. Take this as the reference point. From here, you take an angle beta. Take a small angle beta, d beta, in the direction of beta dash d beta. This is d beta. What is the mass of this part of chain? Dm would be equal to r d beta into lambda. Because r d beta is this arc, small arc, is r d beta. So it is r m upon l into d beta is dm. What is the gravitational potential energy of this mass dm with reference to center? What is this height? This height is r cos beta. This height is r cos beta. So the energy, gravitational energy, is r upon l m r cos beta d beta. The total energy of the chain at this situation would be theta. Beta is varying from 0 to alpha. From 0 to alpha, and alpha is what? L upon R. We can write to L upon R. So this energy would be R square M upon L sine beta 0 to L upon R, which is equal to M R square upon L. G also, we have not written G. G has to be multiplied because gravitational. So energy we have to find out. G times sine beta 0 to L upon R. G times sine L upon R. This is the initial energy. That is energy at this point of time. What is the energy when the new location is this? Now again take an angle beta dash, take d beta dash, a small element. What is the gravitational energy of the chain? Formula would be same, only limits will change. The total energy U2 of the chain now will be G R square M upon L. cos beta d beta integrated cos beta dash, this time it will be beta dash d beta integrated, it is sine beta dash. Beta dash is varying from this angle, now will be theta. It is varying from theta. Initially it was from 0 to alpha. Now it is from theta to theta plus alpha. So the new potential energy is G R square M upon L sine theta plus alpha minus sine theta is the new energy, the potential energy at this point. Total mechanical energy has to be constant. Initial velocity was zero. So this one, the initial total energy is this, will be equal to U1 would be equal to U2 plus kinetic energy. So kinetic energy will be equal to U1 minus U2. Subtract from U1 the U2, you will get M R square G upon L would be common sine L upon R plus sine theta minus sine theta plus L upon R is the kinetic energy at this point, which is half m v square. From this we can easily get the value of v, cancel m, take 2 here and take now under root of this. So this is the answer number 2. Answer number 1 was that mr square g upon l sine l upon r was the gravitational energy. The velocity would be this. Now we have to find out what is the, it may appear slightly confusing, so I just want to clarify it, how the third part of the question, that is the tangential acceleration when the train when the chain just starts falling down. So what we have to see for finding part 3 is that when the chain has just started sliding down, take each element separately and take an angle as usual, beta d beta dash d beta, sorry, not beta dash. This whole angle is alpha. Alpha is equal to L upon R. Now see what is the downward weight of this component is M upon L, which is lambda. R d beta is the length of this, so this is the mass of this small component. This mass, if you take in a rotational motion, if you take chain, a segment which is rotating like this along point O, this mass, this weight is providing a torque about O, and to find the torque about any point we have to draw a straight line normal to that force which is giving the torque, so and multiply it. So what is value of this? This is R sine beta, this one, this is R, this is beta, so the this part is R sine beta. So the torque provided by this small element, I will write d torque is equal to M upon L R into R sine beta d beta into G. G is the gravity. Total torque, you integrate it, how much it is coming? It is coming M R square upon L. G is also there, sin beta will be minus cos beta, and limits are from 0 to alpha. 0 to alpha is L upon R. So it is gm R square upon L. It will become minus cos L upon R plus 1. So it is 1 minus cos L upon R is the value of the total torque. What is total torque? Is I alpha? What is I for this chain? Whole mass is at a distance r. It is mr square. What is alpha? Alpha will be a upon r. We have to find out this only. Acceleration. Tangential acceleration. So write like this. Mr square into a upon r is equal to gmr square upon l. 1 minus cos theta L upon R. Now solve it. M gets cancelled. So it comes to A is equal to G R upon L. 1 minus cos L upon R. In place of theta, it is L upon R. So this is the answer for the tangential acceleration. So that solves the problem. Thank you.